Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. This is Dax Query View and Power BI Desktop. When it first came out, people wanted more features and more capabilities. Well, guess what? Zoe Douglas and the team at Microsoft, they're continuing to deliver. Now, if you wanted to query a data model that was published out to Power BI, what would you do? You would use SQL Server Management Studio or some other tool. If you wanted to add multiple measures in one DAX query, what would you do? You would use some other third-party tool. Well, guess what? Now, you don't have to leave Power BI Desktop. Microsoft has made those capabilities available directly in the query view. You want to see? Well, you know how we like to do. Enough of all this talking. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. I'm live connected to a model that's published out to the service. I don't want to do anything. I just want to run some queries against this model. Look at this. I'm live connected. I have the query view. If I want to, I can say evaluate, summarize columns, and then I can start writing out a query. For example, let's get rid of this. Adam always makes fun of my typing, but let's say calendar year. And then we want to see total sales. There we go, total sales amount, and close it out. Now I can run this query directly against that semantic model that's published out to the service without connecting to some other tool. I'm just using Power BI Desktop. That's one of the great things that they just recently released. And so you can do lots of things with this connection. So you don't have to create visuals. You can just go right to this query view and start writing your queries, but you can't quite add them yet when you're live connected. Let me show you what I'm talking about. And so if I came here, I only wanted to see sales for red products. So I can say define measure. We're gonna put it on the internet sales table, and we're gonna call my measure total red sales. And then I write my measure. So I'll say calculate, then I'm gonna use total sales amount as measure, and then I'm gonna say color equals red, just like that, right? So I've defined that measure, and now I can use it, red sales, and then I'm gonna go right here and then say total red sales. See, it picks it up, and I can run it, and there you go. It doesn't appear that it's available when you're live connected, but if I'm working in that model, wait, let me show you, because this is too exciting. So let's say I go over to the model. So I have the actual model opened up. You can see here, I don't have any measures in this model. If you go to the model, you can see there's no measures, and I wanna add measures. Now, what I can do, I'm not gonna make you watch me type this. So here's my measure. And you notice it says update or add this measure. So I can do that, okay? What if I add a few more measures? Because a lot of people are like, hey, we wanna add multiple measures. And now what you can see right now, I have the ability to add them individually, or I can just pick update model with changes. Now, maybe you don't realize the significance in this, because before, you had to right click on the table or use the ribbon to say new measure, paste that measure in, create that measure. Repeat, rinse, wash, repeat, rinse, wash, repeat. Now, in the query view, I could write all this up and say, update my model with the changes. Are you sure? Yes. And there's all my measures. I could even come back and say, format this up, and then update my measures. And now all my measures are nice and formatted. So if I go here and take a look, you can see how nicely formatted all my measures are. And I did this right in Power BI Desktop. You know what Marco says, right? It's not DAX unless it's formatted. Well, all this is DAX. Now, simple DAX, but it's absolutely DAX. All right, what do you think? Are you digging? Are you liking this new query view and all the features that they keep releasing? I know I am. But if you have any questions, comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Fabric, more about Power BI, all the great features in Power BI and Fabric, there's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.